Testing? Okay, welcome to the video. So here's the question we're looking at. We've got two events, event A, and they tell us it has probability 0.34, and event B has probability 0.21, and then they say assume that A and B are disjoint events. Now it's going to be important to pay close attention to this vocab word disjoint here to answer this question and to get a sense of really what's happening here. So let's take a minute and think about when we say two events are disjoint, the statistical definition means they have no outcomes in common. So one way we could think about it, I think it's always helpful to have a real life example, we could say, well, let event A be the probability I wake up before 6 a.m. and event B be the probability I wake up between 6 a.m. and 7 a.m. So it looks like there's a 34% chance I wake up before 6 a.m., 21% chance I wake up between 6 and 7. So those would be disjoint events because they have no outcomes in common, meaning they can't both happen. On any given day, it can't be true that I wake up before 6 a.m. and I wake up between 6 and 7 a.m. I guess assuming we're talking about the first time I wake up, we're not hitting the snooze button here. So let me write that down just for our record. So disjoint events have no outcomes in common. Another way to think about it is they cannot both. They can't both occur at the same time. All right, so with that in mind, let's go look at the question that's being asked here. They're asking for the probability that both events occur. So if we look back at what we just wrote up there, we said they can't both occur. So they said, what's the probability that both events occur? And then they're writing that in statistical notation. They're saying that would be A and B occur. Well, we know it's impossible for them both to occur. I can't wake up before 6 a.m. and also wake up between 6 and 7 a.m. So in statistics, when we have an event that is impossible to occur, what probability do we assign to that event? Zero. If something is impossible to occur, we give it zero probability. So that will be our answer here. Take a minute and notice how this question is different than some of the other questions in the homework, where instead of seeing the word and here for disjoint events, you might see the word or. If the word is or here, we would solve the question in a different way.